Shoes? I have lots of shoes. I have probably... because it's my part of my job, it's like a uniform. My shoes make my outfits. Okay, so keep that in mind, but I have about... probably about... I don't know, 200 maybe? Probably, right? I have 200 pairs of shoes, but they're not all in the same place. And the funnier part is usually what I'm wearing is rubber boots because I live in Canada and it snows and it rains, so I'm usually in fisherman boots. But I have 200 pairs of high heels hidden somewhere. I'm super excited. It's the beginning of Mi Plan, my tour, and it's my first real sort of tour of Latin America. I mean, I've been to Mexico in the past, I've been to Brazil and Chile, but this is sort of more like a focused tour just for Latin America, and it's based on, you know, my album Mi Plan, which is my first Latin album. And we kicked off the tour in Guadalajara the other night, and it was my first time in Guadalajara, and it was amazing, it was incredible. Fans were so into it, dancing, singing. It was a great way to start.
Fast that time, right? That was fine? Oh, okay, cool.
It all started when I was a little girl and I started singing in Portuguese. I used to sing with my cavaquinho when I was only 9 years old with my Portuguese outfit on and sang a song. Adeus, São Miguel, meu amor. And the first song I ever sang was with my mother, and we sang a song that was a contemporary adaptation of a very popular Azorean American artist named Jorge Ferreira. And he sang a song called Canção do Pai, because he used to sing with his daughter, and they did this duet, and it was like, Pai, minha filha. And they all sang together. And so my mom changed the lyrics to a mother and daughter song, because she sang, my father didn't perform as much. Although my dad would take me to see Desafio. Desafio is like the music of the street. It's people playing guitar and trading verses, but they're ad-libbing, they're freestyling. So my dad would take me to watch these things. And so that is where I learned how to be an MC. And when I say an MC, I mean the ability to just get up on stage, grab the microphone, and take over the crowd with just your voice.
I'm Catherine, and I've been Nelly's assistant for 3 years now, and I'm one of her stylists. And this tour was a lot of fun because we actually worked together, Nelly and I, to design all the outfits that she's been wearing on stage, including her singer's outfits.
Me and my stylist and my wardrobe seamstress, we just like tore all these magazine pages out and we made this book, and then like we got all these fabric samples and we went into the tailor's shop and we were like little mice, you know, working on this fabulous outfits for the shows.
Everything has sequins or sparkle or anything shiny to catch the light for stage, which is always key. Got some sequin pants, these awesome jackets. They're actually quite heavy. She's got crazy endurance to be able to wear all this stuff.
I love clothes. I have four seamstresses in my family. So when I was little, I used to draw pictures of dresses, and my aunt, my godmother, she would make the dress for me. So I got to design my prom dress. I got to design like different dresses for like religious festivals. All the time, I was designing a new dress. So it was fun.
Ese es el plan del mejor club que hay. Nelly Furtado, México. Ra, ra, ra. Woo!
tal, gente? Yo soy Javier García, cantante, también haciendo coros con Nelly Furtado, aquí aprovechando de esta gira que me han ofrecido para abrir para ella y para cantar con ella. Y nada, os quiero enseñar un poquito la gente que está en la banda. Síganme, vamos a dar una vuelta. La verdad que a mí me querían pagar, pero le dije que solo si me dan de comer está bien. Eso es suficiente.
This is from when we were in Guadalajara, the fan club gave her all these little things. And everywhere we go, the fans always give her things. And instead of just, you know, packing them away and taking them home to Toronto and, you know, putting them in storage, I think it's nice to have them out so she can look at them while she's getting ready. And, you know, it just, I mean, you are my inspiration. Awesome. It's really nice to have out and for her to look at. She likes it a lot.
I love all the social media. It's fun. And I think that for me, Twitter's been like a nice revelation for me to connect with my fans on a more intimate level and also share news directly, share messages directly, share stories about my music. Addicted. I really like Twitter. And I was such a skeptic when I first was introduced to it. I was just, oh, what a, you know, I wasn't very open. And once I started using it, I really kind of fell in love with it. And it's a great outlet. It's fun. And I love people, you know, so I like, I know what it's like to be a fan too and enjoy and want to know more and ask questions. And sometimes it's hard to try to catch up on every interview or on every, you know, it's of your favorite artist. So Twitter's a nice way to get the message direct from their mouth. Actually, one time I couldn't figure out what kind of hair to wear. I couldn't decide if I wanted to wear my hair up or down. And it was like half an hour before the TV show, so I sent a tweet out. Do you think I should wear my hair down or up tonight? And then it's like tic-tac, it's like any mini miny mo. And so I got like maybe, I don't know, 50 responses, so I just counted them, and then the hair up won that night. So it's fun.
Please don't go, I love you so. And I want you to know that I...
Ahora vamos para el estudio. Boombox, all access. No te vayas. Quédate aquí. Don't move. Stay here. It's gonna get fun.
Hey, we're here in Mexico City and we're at the studio. And when I'm on the road and I have a day off, I like to come to the studio and make music. And I'm recording my album right now, Lifestyle. So we've got a day to jam and record some vocals. Let's go check it out. I always had songs in my head when I was a child, from as long as I can remember, 3 years old, 4 years old. But I didn't start formally writing them down as songs until I was 12. And then I would feel notebooks and notebooks full of songs. This is the studio, isn't it nice? I love it, it's so nice. This is the mix board where it's just the mix room, so just kind of get your ideas together in here. I like to write in this room. Actually, usually I just pull out a 58 microphone, real simple. I actually got the idea from Bono from U2, that's how he writes his songs. He has the whole band in here, and he takes a microphone and just, you put, your voice through the speakers with the music and just kind of jam that way. I wrote poems too. I wrote poetry and sometimes stories. Yeah, I think for me it just, when I write a song, it's, I usually learn something about myself. Something that I might not have understood before I wrote the song. It's almost like a code or something. It's like a code, a mathematical equation.
A ver, ven que os voy a presentar alguna gente de la banda. Esta señora aquí, preciosa, se llama Anita, di hola a la cámara, corista de Nelly. Este hombre aquí no entiende nada de lo que estoy diciendo, se llama Joel. Catherine, la entrena... Esta es Catherine, es que tengo las gafas mal. Esta es Catherine y esta es la asistente. Y aquí tenemos a la entrenadora y nutricionista y todo, toda la comida. Y esa es, do know your name, pero me está poniendo así, se me olvida. Es que es tan guapa Maggie que me confundo y se me olvida el nombre siempre.
my new band I'm working with. They don't have to sing, they're just gonna lip sync. I have the song ready. They're just gonna Milli Vanilli it.
I had a lot of friends in high school, junior high, and what I used to do after school is I used to get on the bus and go downtown and hang out at the mall. And all the kids in the city that rapped would hang out, and we would all just sit around and rap. That's how I got into rapping. I mean, my style is singing. I sing, you know, but I like to spontaneously make up melodies and lyrics and things. But for a time, I did write rhymes. I did. Bajo is a really cool song. Julieta wrote the song for me. She sent it to me, and I loved it right away. And then we invited La Mala Rodriguez from España to come and sing.
La Mala.
I was kind of in shock, actually. I was kind of like, it felt more like a dream. Because you don't get a chance to record with girls that often. And so the opportunity to record with not one girl, but two, the three girls, was like, it's kind of like a slumber party, but without any sleeping bags. It was just kind of like, yee-hoo.
Got your song ready? We're gonna cut it in 2 minutes, okay? The song's called Ooh Baby Baby, Please Don't Go. Please don't go. Please don't go. I love you so, and I want you to know that I'm gonna miss your love the minute you walk through that door. Please don't go. Anyway, right here. Wow, this is a cool microphone. One funny thing that happened was when we were in the booth, we decided to record one part of the song totally together around the same microphone. And Julieta was being shy. She was like, oh, no me gusta mucho de improvisar. Oh, no sé, no sé. And then when she started singing, she's all like, el calor de mi vida cambió. And we're like, whoa, Julieta. Somebody was being very super humilde about her improvisational skills. So that was funny, because like the three of us, La Mala and I, are more like, yeah, we're more like rappers, you know, we're more like more the hip hop spirit. And but Julieta, she is too, but she doesn't always show it. She has a side of her that's super strong.
¿Tú me puedes servir algo?
¿Quieres que te sirva y comida?
No sé, mamita. Yo la llamo mamanita porque ella siempre nos está cuidando. Es como que la que sabe el horario de todo lo que está pasando en el tour. Un poquito de eso y un poquito de arroz, por favor. Mamanita. ¿Queda raro, mamanita? Un poquito.
Tantito.
Mamita Anita mejor, ¿no?
Sí, mejor.
Mamita Anita. Y ahí en el sombrero...
Nunca he tenido hijos más grandes, ¿eh? Más, vamos, que no se portan muy bien, que digamos.
Yo sí me porto bien, ¿eh? No digas eso. ¿Me sirve sopa también? Es como me cuidan. Así no me tienen que pagar comida y amor. Eso es todo lo que necesito. Luego voy a comer un ratito y después os llevo a presentar al resto de la banda, ¿ok? Dale, déjame comer, por favor.
This is where I need to be, right here, making the hits for you. Los éxitos para ti. In the studio here in Mexico City. Ready? I'm ready for right.
Latest hit. One, two, one, two, yeah.
And it's mad ball.
Yeah, I'm the kind of guy that likes to hang around in hotel lobbies. I like to jump around.
Hey, look, yeah, okay, they've almost got it down. All right, girls. I think this is gonna be great.
Hola, soy Nelly Furtado. Estás aquí con Boombox All Access.
Only on Boomerang. Vamos a ver si vemos algunos de la banda. Algunos han ido, pero a ver qué pillamos por ahí en los camerinos. A lo mejor les pillamos indecentes, que sería bastante bueno eso. Y aquí tenemos la maquillista, no te escapes, que le gusta mucho la cámara.
¡Mentira!
El percusionista, percusionista de la banda.
¿Cómo están?
Es venezolano, pero vive en...
En Toronto.
¿Y cuánto tiempo llevas con él?
10 años casi. Off and on.
Mi Plan is a very international album. I recorded with Alex Cuba. The cool thing about Alex was he didn't really know any of my music before meeting me. He just met me and I was just Nelly the singer. I wasn't Nelly Furtado, global recording artist. He didn't know anything about that and he didn't care. And it wasn't until I got in the studio and I sang a song for him that he translated for me, the song was Mi Plan, that he completely changed his attitude about it. Right when I met him, I already knew I wanted to work with him. He didn't know right away till after he heard me. My audition.
Hola amigo, mi nombre es Hani, la maquillista de Nelly Furtado y ahorita vamos backstage al cuarto. Yeah. Okay, vamos a ir al cuarto donde están todos los secretos de la belleza. Pasen.
Aquí tenemos a otro gran músico que tampoco no entiende nada de lo que estamos hablando.
Oh.
Sí.
Oh.
Que se llama Sean Kelly. Sean Kelly es el guitarrista de Nelly.
Y lleva... something?
Estoy guitarrista. How's that? Pretty good.
Tenemos todos los colores, las bases y las sombras que usamos en Nelly. Como pueden ver, ella es súper linda, no necesita tanto maquillaje, todo es súper natural. Los colores que usamos, los bronces, los pinks, los secretos, las brochas. Y no pueden faltar un poquito de lashes.
This is where I record my vocals and I get lonely in here sometimes. And I get bored because it's kind of like playing volleyball. When no one passes you the ball and you're stuck there waiting for the ball and then you kind of get like bored. So I think a perfect studio would have some Zen sand with a rake and you could just rake through the sand. You ever seen those before? No? Okay. So anyway, some, or marbles to play with, something.
I think Nelly is super, super, super profesional, super bella y es super fácil de maquillar y tenerla en esta silla. Se deja llevar por las cosas que yo le recomiendo y ella también tiene su look. Y entonces ella me dice sus cosas y yo le digo las mías, lo mezclamos y hacemos el look del día. So, no es tan difícil. Eso es todo. Ya les di todo el secreto. So, suerte.
What are we gonna play?
You go ahead. All the bluegrass? We know both types of music, country and western.
Well, I'm the kind of guy that likes to hang around in hotel lobbies. I like to jump around. I like to eat a lot. Hang around with Danny.
I like to cook. I like to cook at home. I also like to bake cookies and breads and cakes. With my daughter, when we're bored, we like to like break out the flour and the butter and the sugar and the mixer and just kind of cook and have fun.
Yes!
It is a passion flowing right on through your veins, and it's the feeling like you're always so glad you came.
If you want to make cookies that are really healthy, instead of butter, you can use applesauce. And instead of sugar, you can use agave nectar or maple syrup, Canadian maple syrup. Flour, there's a lot of different choices. You can use spelt flour, maybe rice flour, and instead of regular milk you can use soy milk, and to add like some fat like butter you can put almond butter or peanut butter.
It is the golden dream, the yellow and the gray, the red and sweat and tears of
the... Hey, look, yeah, okay, they've almost got it down. girls, I think this is gonna be great. This is gonna be the next big girl band. Made in Mexico. Wow! Fuerza! Thanks for having me, it's been a blast. Love you, thank you. Woo, all access. All access. Wah, wah.
Hello, my name is Javier Garcia. Who are you?
I'm Sean Kelly.
Who are you? Only on Boombox All Access.
Turn it up.
Maria Zine de Chadinha, Maria de Chadinha, Maria que chegar o bacalhau era tão sabroso.